The ATC is basically set up for customers to take a test drive of the equipment.
Well, I think it's the value that our customers see in this truly sandbox environment where they can make a failure happen before it happens in their own environment. For a traditional customer to see all of these technologies put together in a single place, I think is huge value. Otherwise, they're going to have to go out to all these large manufacturers, they're going to have to make all these travel plans, they're going to have to try to see all these technologies working side by side in an unbiased way, which is sometimes hard to get when you go to a certain OEM. Our customers are continually coming to us with more requests for more proof of concepts, more labs as a service. So that's going to continue to drive our need to provide more flexible, agile space for them to play in.
The efficiency of what we did with this environment and the way that we can duplicate how we build these particular pods in a 1,600 square foot footprint is huge for us. The racks themselves, one of the architectures that we have in them, none of the cables actually leave the rack. They're all internal to the actual rack itself. So in the event that we need to remove an entire rack out of the solution and throw another one in there because it needs to be a different size or different weight, we can do that with the way that we designed this room.
My first customer, a lot of cases, is our own internal engineers that are working on a project. So I will get a request from them for something that is not typical off the shelf. So whether it's racks that need to be wider, deeper, different colors, I will then go to our partners over at the APC Schneider folks and say, we need something that you don't have. Here's the challenge that the customer has. And it's oftentimes we'll see two or three solutions come back. Well, here's an option that might work. Here's an option that might work. It's a very collaborative approach where we can go directly back to the customer with multiple options. So we really view them as an extension to the worldwide engineering team.
There was no SKU out there for this particular width and depth that we were looking for, along with the height. So working with the rack team over at Schneider, they helped develop the actual solution and then some different scenarios for cable management that were developed to help us maximize our generic rack that we like to use, because we don't want to build one rack for a particular solution. We want to be able to quickly address every solution with one rack. And we couldn't have done that without that team at Schneider. When you're building out these environments, you're paying for square footage, you're not paying for cubic footage. So let's build them out as tall as we possibly can. Majority of the time in a rack, you're gonna find that the top two U's of your rack are wasted anyway. It's all administrative type, patching and switching and your core connectivity. And everything below those 10 U's is generally all of your infrastructure. So why not take that administrative level, add additional 10 U's on top of the rack, and it'll still allow us to have the full 42 U's, and our cost per U actually came down drastically when we went from a 42 U to a 52 U rack, allowing us almost 30 more racks overall when we added the 10 U's in the same footprint. That was huge cost savings and allows us the flexibility to be able to do more in the same rack. When we had originally built out our ATC, we didn't know exactly what we wanted, and there was a lot of confusion. We had about 20,000 square feet dedicated in our warehouse, and we had 8 people doing nothing but configuring racks and setting rails and getting things put in there. I reached out to the Schneider team. I asked for a quote of what it would cost to have that all done for me ahead of time. And the quote came back so unbelievably cost-effective that it was no-brainer to allow Schneider to go ahead and integrate everything in for us. Because the timeliness of the deliveries, I didn't have to have these racks being stored in a 20,000 square foot warehouse. We literally knew what day we were gonna need them in. We told Schneider what day to deliver these racks on. They showed up on that particular day. They had installers that showed up, rolled them into space. And we went from a just open nothing room to a data center in literally a day. It was amazing how quickly it happened.